Yes, how's everybody doing? I hope you're doing well. Like I say, I don't make videos until it gets closer to the date. Here's another day gone, and we're getting closer to the 8th and the 9th and the 11th. This was given to me by a YouTube subscriber, and I just subscribed to this guy on my phone. But he's talking about the same thing. Now, 88, I have said, anyway, I will go over this. I guess it's not immaterial. But here's the video. Some people say I don't show whose video it's from, but I've told people if they need information, they can just email me and I'll send you whatever. So here's the YouTube channel, my brother. This was given to me by a YouTube subscriber, so let's play it.
With an obscure concentration camp symbol on them. This is, I'm going to show you how he's fighting, putting a ritual against, he's tied himself to number 88, okay? 88. He's tied that right here. The campaign placed 88 ads with an obscure concentration camp symbol on them. This is, I'm going to show you how he's fighting, putting a ritual against the harvest of the church because he don't want it to happen. He likes this earth and he likes to think, well, he likes to think it's, the riches of it. On Wednesday, the Trump campaign placed 88 ads on Facebook. 88 is a number with Nazi connotations. It's a feature symbol used by Nazis to denote political prisoners in concentration camps because that's what he is. Well,
So he showed that 88, Trump tweeted out 88 symbol, symbolism, 88.
there's a conjunction in the constellation of the line Leo on 8 and 8, August the 8th. So what I'm saying is from now until September 23rd, I think it's very high watch dates for a harvest or a rapture because this thing creates a lot of different kind of frequencies. When this happens, this conjunction in the constellation of the line, it's creating a portal opening with a different light. So that's what I'm gonna read you here. Just read a little bit about it here. Because there's a the Sirius star is the brightest star in the sky. It's sometimes called the summer, I mean the summer star or something like that, but this is in alignment. This is making an alignment. Sirius is rising in the east on the 8th and 8th. It's called the bright and morning star, and because it's the most brightest star in the sky except for the sun. And so whenever this happens, it lines up with Orion's belt. This alignment aligns up with our Orion's belt. And over in Job, it talks, God's asking Job, can you loosen the bands of Orion? I think it's talking about the rapture. Now, I don't have time to do a lot of scriptures and stuff on here.
So, yes, I agree with him. He's saying the same thing I did right here. I made my video right here. Wow, are you serious about this right here? So, this goes with my video that I made, but he brought up the situation with Trump with the 88 back here, which he tweeted out. 88 right in here, and Orion's belt right here. Campaign placed 88 ads right here. So I agree with them, but also too, as he said, the Pleiades meteor shower peaks the 11th right here, 11th and 12th, some places. I think this is the Saturday night, or excuse me, the 11th. I think this is Tuesday. 11th right here is Wednesday. So it peaks right in here. This is what we're looking at. He's talking about 88 right here that I had verses on this one about the new moon. Be gone. So I've had verses on this. So this is right here, the Pleiades. This is a meteor shower. Also, too, says right here, Pleiades, and he, as he said, Orion, Pleiades meteor shower, right here. This is a day later, but it's also St. Lawrence because it peaks near the date of Saint's martyrdom at August 10th. Then, of course, I have had this before. Seeketh him that maketh the seven stars in Orion, and turn the shadow of death into morning, maketh the day dark into the night, and calleth the waters of the sea, poureth. I had this in one of my videos, so that's what he's talking about, and it is in Job too. So this is the first part of my video. The lion's gate is opened, and I will refresh your memory on this is also lines up with the pyramids, and I will refresh your memory on that. So anyway, love you all. This is the first part of my video. Yes, this is what he was talking about. I found an article on this. It says, I will put his video though. It says the alignment of Earth, the stars in Sirius. It says the star Sirius rises in the sky. Orion belt directly aligns with the pyramids in Gaza and form a perspective from Earth. It appears that Sirius, the brightest star we can see, comes closer to Earth. For a little cosmic perspective is twice the size of the sun, this right here, brighter. It says, this is the lion's gate, is such profound, right here. It says right here, why is it called the Lion's Gate? Also, too, which means the time around 8-8, the Lion's Gate is powerful, manifest. Anyway, the Lion's Gate is on 8-8, and portal opens, whatever he was talking about. So I just wanted to give this information. Also, too, this was very interesting to me because it shows in IPEC GOAT, the last scene, the pyramids lining up right here. There's also a meteor shower. There's a meteor shower during this time. Right here. Meteor shower. It's the Pleiades right here. Pleiades, as I showed you here with the Bible verse. Right here. Amos 5:8 right here. Shadow of death into morning. Well, it's pretty interesting here also is that it's lined up and then it shows the meteors. Boom. There's one over there. So, yes, this is what I'm watching. High watch. I hope you're all doing well. I'll add this on to my end of my video. So that's 8-8 and then 8-11. I'm not really going to get into the 21st yet, but 21st, but this is the days I'm watching right here. God bless, and that's a week away. God bless. We'll see what happens.